Welcome to what is probably the shortest episode of Unlapped Heroes and my lowest moment in 10 years of owning my car. Once more, after 12 months of waiting, my car is broken.
And the old nerve-wracking scene, for that matter, is taking itself so seriously. For a lot of people. And we don't like them.
You can take whatever the fuck you have,
take it
and go out and drive it.
There is a reason I'm doing this alone and I don't have the guys here.
It doesn't matter how much I try to explain the situation to you, you can't get the full picture. This guy is struggling with his car, one way or another, for more...
The last 14 months.
Exactly, throwing money at it without resorting to anything, if not my laughter and happiness.
So let's take it from the start. What happened? A lot of bad things have happened with my car the last couple of months. You have seen the car being broken, towed, being impounded by the police. A lot of different things have happened and nothing fazed me. The car even got fire in Greece and I still said, no, I will keep pushing, I will keep doing, I will fix the car. I will focus on my goal. A lot of people think that is the lap time is the goal, going under 8 is the goal. But in essence, what we just want is we just want to drive our cars. This is all that you care about. After a point, this is all that you care about. You only just want to go out there and drive your car. You're good with anything. You're good with 180 horsepower and you are good with 220 horsepower. And you're good with anything in between. It might be 805 and it might be 745. At the end of the day, this makes zero difference. It's not that you want the brakes or the tires to be perfect. After a point, you just want to drive. I waited almost 8 months for the car to be back together. I didn't rush it. I tested on track and at once, and I tested on track twice, just to be sure that the car is working and all the kinks are fixed. And when I finally decided to bring the car in Germany and drive all these 2,000 kilometers from Greece to Germany, I never actually believed that there will be new problems. Of course, it's a complicated car. There's a lot of things that are different from a stock car. There is always going to be a small issue here and there. But to be honest, I never believed that there would be another breakdown. So I went out, I did a slow lap just to scrub the tires in. And then I did another lap. And in the middle of that lap, I felt the car going down on power. And I said, this is impossible. I have only done 3 laps. It's impossible, I actually have a problem. But unfortunately, that was a sound I've heard before in my life. And it's the sound of the manifold leaking pressure. So this is probably why I was losing power. I slowly crippled out of the truck. I opened the hood and I was trying to see what was the problem. And while doing that, I actually realized that there is another problem there. The crankshaft pulley has actually seared 3 bolts. There is actually one broken bolt there. And it's being held in place only by one single bolt. And I say, fuck, this is impossible. And as I'm trying to take stuff out and trying to see what was the original problem, because you remember, the problem was actually the car going down on power. So we realized that the turbo has also backed off the manifold. And doing this, we found some oil inside the boost hoses. And going from point to point to point, we took out the spark plugs. And we're afraid that we might have a situation that is completely unexpected. We were closer to an under 8 lap time. Closer than ever. And this still means nothing. There is no pleasure out of that. The only thing that I know is that you spent 12 months of waiting. You spent a ton of money trying to get the car back together. And you're back to square zero. You have nothing. You basically have a non-working car and you are looking forward to having the engine removed again. And we try to be very adamant here and we try to share openly when we succeed and we try to share openly where we fail. And this whole thing is supposed to be fun, and the moment it stops being fun, you should reevaluate why you're doing all this. And I think for us this is this point.